And lastly, if you feel all these things are too big for you to handle, and you have a partner, I mean, I'm talking about partner, I mean your husband or your wife, not boyfriend, girlfriend, because, you know, people can ask on anything.
Guys, welcome back to my channel, Dr. Dede here. So today we're talking about how to save money. I think maybe what I'm going to say today is probably on how to save money in Nigeria, because I know a lot of my Nigerian people are struggling to save money. So I already have a blog post on how to save money that I wrote last year, but this video is like an updated version of it. So how do you save money? I feel, first of all, the most important part is having a budget plan, a monthly budget plan. If you're employed or you have a business and you have a particular amount that enters your account every month, you need to have a spending plan according to what you get in a month. Do you get what I'm saying? So first of all, how do you have a monthly plan? You have to have a prioritized plan on what you need to do in a month. So if it's housing, if it's on food, transportation, fuel for your gen, because, you know, we have NEPA problems in this country, just for you to have a prioritized plan on how you're going to spend your money in a month. What do you do next? You allocate how much you can spend on those things based on your monthly allowance. So that is the step one. Have a prioritized plan on how you're going to spend in a month. Then secondly, have a plan that will spend less than you earn. That is how you're going to save. You don't plan on, okay, maybe for example, I get 120,000 in a month. Don't plan your whole budget spending allocation on 120,000. So you plan as if you get 80,000. It depends on you, on the formula you want to use. But for the purpose of this video, let's say you're saving 40,000 out of 120,000 in a month. So your budget plan for the month should be based on 80,000. So it could be on housing, it could be on food, it could be on electricity, you know, all those bills that you have to pay in a month. Budget them on your 80,000, including having the extra just for emergencies. Yes, your emergency is not from your savings. That's correct. Then from the 40,000, it could go in different ways. First of all, you could have different bank accounts. So if you are employed, you could ask your employer to split your monthly allowance into two different accounts. So one account is probably your current account that receives the money you have to spend in a month, and the second one will be your savings account. Now for the savings account, I don't know if I'm breaking it down in too many babies, but in your savings account, yeah, it can be two ways. It could be a savings account that is just there, maybe some little monthly interest to come in, or you could actually fix deposits your savings account. Another thing I should mention is that if you are going to have two accounts, one account should be one you don't have any ATM bank card to, you don't have any access to, you don't have any online banking. The only way you can get money from that account is if you go to your bank in person and withdraw. That is how you'll be able to curb your spending habits, by not having access to your savings account. So that one aside, you could tell your bank that you want to fix a particular amount, or basically I think you should just fix your old savings, because that's why it says your savings account, so don't divide it again and cause confusion. So your savings account, you can actually say you want to fix deposit, ask for the best interest possible. Some bank officers are actually quite nice and they give you a very good rate depending on the day you go and depending on the bank terms. So you could get a good rate, like per annum rate, that they will divide into I think four, so that you can get it every 3 months. And also, if you decide to be getting it every 3 months, you also have to let them know that they should not push it to your current account. It should remain in that savings. Whatever interest you're getting should remain in the savings, and when they need to book you a new term, it should be overturned and everything should be added together, so that way your money is like accumulating and expanding. So now we're done with that in terms of savings. Like I mentioned, make sure you don't have any access to your savings account. It will just help you. And before you even walk to the bank to say you want to withdraw, you'll have given it a very good thought. So maybe it is very, very deep emergency that you don't have any other choice than to take out of your savings account. And be warned though, if you decide to cut your fixed deposit earlier than the maturity date, you're going to pay a fee. So do you want to risk it? And I think the fee is actually quite big. Sometimes they could say 25% or something. Yeah, it's ridiculous because they don't want you to cut it. So it's just a way to also help you curb the temptation to say you want to break the deposit. So yeah, after you have those two, I think another very good thing you can do in Nigeria is to invest. It depends on how much you have to invest, obviously. I don't think there's anything tangible to invest 1,000 naira in these days, especially now that stock market is on a downhill and very unpredictable. But if you have a big amount of money that you just don't like the fact that it's sitting down doing nothing, it could be giving you fixed deposit interest rate, but you're still not satisfied, you want to invest big time into it, then I'll suggest property. That is the number one thing someone can invest in Nigeria. It could be land somewhere that is not yet developed. In a very few years to come, that place could be developed and could be worth a lot of money. So the first thing you can do is buy land. Obviously, if you buy land, make sure you fence it so that someone will not come and say you stole land or something. Mark your territory when you buy land and make sure you do it the legit way and not some way that it will bring you discomfort in the future. So obviously you can buy land, and you can also invest in already developed properties. It could be a flat, it could be a whole building, depending on how rich you are blessed at this point in time. So you could invest majorly in properties in Nigeria. And then secondly, you can also invest as an angel investor. It could be your friend's business, it could be a very promising budding company that needs like a very big investment, and you actually have seen the terms, you've seen the conditions, and you've seen that this company can grow, and you're very sure that there's going to be major return of investment for you. So that's the only way you should be an angel investor and invest in someone's business. And perhaps maybe you're a business person, you're an entrepreneur like me, and you have that money too, but you're a bit conflicted if you should put it in your business or you should keep it in your savings account. I'll say it's better you invest in your business, because you already know the potential your business has, and with God's grace, your business will actually grow and bring you more blessings and more money in return. So yes, you can also invest in your own business. You can be your own angel investor. It is your own, so why would you be selfish to yourself? You can invest in your own business. And you can also invest in agriculture. I mean, right now, we already know that Nigeria is on the verge of collapsing because of this oil thing. But agriculture seems to be coming up these days. I think agriculture is beginning to come up again. So you can invest in agriculture. It could be poultry farming, it could be fish farming. I've heard of fish farming being very, very lucrative. So you can invest in fish farming, agriculture, poultry, what else? Crops, cocoa, anything you want to invest in, you can invest in it. It could be maybe you giving little loans to people that are actually doing it, or you could be the one starting it. It is also going to be your business, and in a way, you're actually building your empire. Yes. You can save by having the piggy bank. Some people, it works for them. So maybe every day you come back from work, anywhere you go to, and you have some loose chains in your pocket, just deposit them in the piggy bank. Sometimes you just never know. In fact, you forget that you even have a piggy bank sometimes, and when you eventually remember, you open it, you see like loads of money there. The savings fixed deposit is actually better, because the interest will keep on building than piggy bank. But just to even start the cultivating habit, you can start with piggy bank in your room, or just a jar that you can put some coins in or some paper notes and anything like that. Then lastly, if you feel all these things are too big for you to handle and you have a partner, and when I'm talking about partner, I mean your husband or your wife, not boyfriend, girlfriend, because you know people can abscond anything. So if you have a partner that is more into savings, you can actually trust them to help you handle them. So maybe put the account in the two of his name, then maybe, I don't know how you're going to do it, because I think money is very tricky and marriages break up because of money these days. But if you trust your partner and you feel they can help you save more, then of course give it all over to them. So guys, that'll be the end of this video. I hope I was able to explain some very few things on how to save in Nigeria. But first and foremost, don't spend more than you earn, and make sure you spend less than you earn. Actually, that is the most important advice from this video. Don't spend more than you can handle and then end up in debt with people and all that. We don't want that kind of life. I beg. We're even happy that Nigeria does not run on credit, so in a way we are actually being helped by the government by not giving us things on credit. If not, people will be in debt, man. So guys, don't go to places you can't afford, don't buy things you cannot afford, and don't buy things that are just like not useful. I know in Nigeria the main things that cost a lot of money is data. see, we have a problem with internet. So if you're watching this and you're an internet guru or data provider, please, I beg, help our market. Help us reduce the cost of this data, because I know I'm actually very, very, very big spender on data, because I have to have internet on my phone. It's just somehow not having internet. So guys, anyways, just curb your spending a bit and happy saving. Thank you for watching. Please like, subscribe, share with your friends that will want to know how to save. And maybe if you want like a written blog post, I already have it. I'll share the link down below. Please make sure you subscribe. I'm really, really keen on that. Thank you very much for watching again. Bye. Till next time.